I know the simple way to get rock and roll. I know the simple way to get you out of control. I can manipulate it like a doll. I say.
And welcome in another episode of DStage Garage, and yet another day of Super Canary build. Yeah, we had some delay, it's already autumn, but as you can see there was some progress, the engine is on its final place. Yeah, the bumper is only put here just to show you how it's gonna look in the end, but nothing is actually connected there, so we still have to connect the cooler, the intercooler, everything else, the electricity, basically everything. So yeah, it's gonna be a lot to do. Yeah, so here's the reinforcement and the final cut.
We start by stripping off the engine and its chamber from a whole bunch of unnecessary parts, like this head vent oil separator. Or these brackets. Or this oil cap extender, which by the way they've made so the cap fits the cam cover without it. How nice of Fiat engineers. Or this fuel vapors filter.
Where I plan to put the intercooler, and I was actually planning to put another metal band here, but the company that sent me those silicones by mistake, instead of sending me also three metal bands, they've actually sent me a silicone one, which is of course probably like 2 to 3 times more expensive, but still I have to somehow manage without the metal band. Of course I could send it back, but I'm too lazy for that. So maybe I will just cut the pipe with some angle and connect that. Remember that this is just a first stage, so with a new bigger turbocharger I will have to rebuild it anyway, so yeah, let it be.
Bigger engine means bigger radiator. In fact, this Skoda favorite part is the biggest non-custom radiator you could possibly fit under the bumper.
So now I'm gonna need to cut about 15 centimeters of this pipe, but I also want it to be at the 45 degrees angle. So what I'm gonna use is this little thingy that I drew and cut based on a website. Yeah, so I'm attaching the address here. It's a really nice website. You can either print it out or you can. It will also give you some points to approximate if you don't have a printer around. And now I just need to wrap it around the pipe. Yep, as you can see I already have a nice angle to cut, a nice line, without even thinking about how I'm supposed to draw it.
Mm-hmm. we need to rearrange one of the main water pipes so it doesn't point straight into our new radiator. There are lots of six-arm spline bit shapes, Torx being probably the most popular. These days in Fiat's vehicles you will often find the ripe bolt in various places. Yep, it would be much easier to do this when we had the engine out, but as usual, you cannot think through each and every step up front. Now we can proceed with radiator's mount. In the meantime, to let more air in, we modify the old bumper as it will stay with us for a while. Speaking of air, one intercooler bracket comes right up. While still in the air topic, we prepare two pieces of intake piping. Here's a tip. If you want the pipe to bend at 40 degrees, just cut it with 20 degrees angle, rotate the two pieces by 180, and there you have it. Thank you, Captain Obvious. Nice clean weld without adding even a tiny bit of material.
Oh yeah! Teak power!
To change the scenery a bit, we replace the old heating system radiator with a brand new one. The old one is still operational, but it had problems with the valve, and it seems simpler just replace the whole setup, which wasn't expensive. Since Michał was already here, he gladly started the process of new loom fabrication. And now, long-awaited hints on VR sensor bracket.
This is the ready bracket that we've created for the VR sensor, and as you can see, the sensor is not exactly centered with the wheel, with the phonic wheel there. So we're gonna have to adjust it a little bit. We'll dismantle the whole thing, make a slot for that screw here and probably also for that one, and move it a little bit to the right side. Okay, let's do it. Okay.
Okay guys, so this is the whole setup and I will show you how the bracket is attached to the car. So it's using three bolts. First of all, this one is going into the original hole on the car mount. So actually this bolt was originally holding the sensor to the original bracket on the car, yeah, on this DJet engine. And now it's going into this slot here that I'm gonna correct a little bit just over here. So it's already long enough, but as you can see it has this angle, so I just need to straighten it out and move the whole thing a millimeter or two into to that side. Yeah, so anyway, this bolt is going into that hole and then connects to the one on the car. Right, there is another hole and another bolt coming right from the bottom through that hole here, and it holds the whole thing from the bottom, so it also prevents it to moving sideways, right? Because that one is not necessarily good for that. And the third bolt, this one, is what holds the sensor to the bracket. And this piece of metal is, as you can see, you can move it and it clamps on the original bracket for the sensor on the T-Jet. Yeah. And it actually is quite rugged, I would say. Yeah. I don't see any problems with that. We just need to center it out. As you can see, there are various cutouts here, like this one. This one prevents it, the whole bracket, to hit this bump. Well, this piece on the T-Jet bracket. Yeah. And when this bolt goes through that hole here, we need those few washers to adjust the thickness of this gap here, let's say. This gap has to be the same size as the thickness of this part of the sensor, and that's more or less what those three washers do here. So there are sort of a distance here to the original bracket on the T-Jet.
As the variable reluctance sensor has a built-in magnet, make sure to clean all metal residue. The whole procedure may look complicated, but it won't take more than 15 minutes. Just the final check, and that's it for today. We're getting closer to finishing the first stage, so stay tuned.